chronic viral hepatitis is caused by two viruses, hepatitis B and hepatitis C. These are viruses that travel in the blood and in bodily fluids, and once they get into the body, they go to the liver. Now, once hepatitis has got into the liver, it will slowly cause damage, slowly cause scarring, and that scarring will build up until eventually the liver is almost completely destroyed. And that's a stage which we call liver cirrhosis. And liver cirrhosis, once it's developed, is very hard to treat. It means the liver is likely to fail. And worse than that, it means the liver is likely to grow a cancer. So for chronic hepatitis C, we have drugs that will cure the virus. And the sort of treatments that I have available today will cure nearly 8 out of 10 people who are infected with hepatitis C. And if you have chronic hepatitis B, we have wonderful drugs that will control it and stop your liver getting damaged. For many people with chronic viral hepatitis, it may not be appropriate to start treatment immediately. And for many people, all we would do is keep a close watch on their liver and just make sure that nothing goes wrong. There are all sorts of different ways of treating viral hepatitis, but the bottom line is that they're all very effective. So hepatitis B is controllable, hepatitis C is curable. Our job now is to find people whilst their livers are still working well and get rid of these viruses before they do permanent damage. One of the problems with the liver is that it's got an enormous reserve, and that means that you can have very serious liver damage and not be aware of it. So you can be a man or a woman in your 40s or 50s, perfectly healthy, with 90% of your liver having been destroyed by these viruses. So because the liver has this massive reserve, people often don't know their liver's damaged, they often don't realise what's going on until the liver is irreversibly destroyed, by which time it's too late. The only way of knowing if you're infected, the only way of knowing how much damage has gone on, is to have the appropriate blood test. Hepatitis B and hepatitis C are blood-borne viruses. They're passed on by blood-to-blood contact. So for hepatitis C, the commonest route of transmission around the world would be from medical needles, from vaccinations, from dental treatment, from hospital care. So hepatitis C is, I'm afraid, a disease that we doctors have helped to transmit around the globe by not properly cleaning our medical equipment. And sadly, in many parts of the world where there isn't the resource to pay for clean needles and single-use medical equipment, hepatitis C transmission carries on. In the Western world, there's hepatitis C in people who inject illegal drugs. So that's a common route of transmission in some communities, but in most parts of the world, that's not a major problem. Hepatitis B is passed on in very much the same way, but hepatitis B can raise to little higher levels in the body, and that means that it can leak out into body fluids. And that means that mothers can infect their children. We know that partners can sometimes infect each other. That's relatively common for hepatitis B, but not hepatitis C. Around the globe, there are big communities that have massive problems with hepatitis. What I'm worried about is that we have a very large number of people who've lived here for many years. They don't see themselves at risk of hepatitis, but because they were born in the developing world, they're at very high risk. So if we don't find these viruses, and if we don't treat them early, people are going to die of cirrhosis, they're going to die of liver cancer. And the tragedy is that that's all fixable if we find people early, we get these viruses identified, and we get them treated. We need to find those people, we need to treat them, we need to stop them dying.